But now I want to see, I want you to see structurally how John organizes his material. And again, his material is absolutely organized. We do not have a moment by moment, year by year, action by action biography of Yeshua. We have a theological biography that is highly interpretive. One of the things that we saw is the movement of something that happens 3 years later to the front, okay? And the reason is for a theological purpose. He's going to take the life of Yeshua and he's going to selectively share with us just enough so that he can accomplish his purpose, which we saw at the end of the book, is so that you may believe. If you are not yet a believer, it is to get you to the point of believing in Yeshua HaMashiach, in Jesus the Messiah. If you are already a believer, it is to bolster your faith and keep on keeping on to believe. And the way that John does this is a way that none of the other gospel writers use. And he organizes his material around Jewish festivals. Around Jewish festivals. And we see that from chapter 2 all the way to chapter 20, leaving only chapter 21. So chapter 1 doesn't have a Jewish festival. Chapter 21, so bookends, they're not attached to Jewish festivals. But from 2 to 20... every single chapter is attached in some way, shape, or form to a Jewish festival for a particular purpose. Because what Jesus is going to be unveiling about himself, the miracle that he is going to choose to do during these in this section, all are tied into the Jewish festivals. So you can see chapter 2, 3, and 4 is Passover. It's the first Passover that we see here. Chapter 5, I have a question mark there. There's lots of discussion because it's not mentioned, it's not specified. The text simply says a Jewish festival. So is it Pentecost? Is it Rosh Hashanah? Doesn't say. Most people think that it's a Passover, but point being, it's not specified because it's not the actual feast that is important in chapter 5. It is, however, the Jewish holy day of Shabbat that is focused on. So we go from Passover, we go to Shabbat, we go from Shabbat in chapter 5, we move back to Passover, potentially Passover number 3 in chapter 6. In chapter 7, we are in tabernacles and the shadow of Sukkot, of tabernacles, the repercussions of this holiday echo on our felt all the way through chapter 9. So 7, 8, and 9 about tabernacles. But in chapter 9, we are introduced to a new theme, a new holiday, and that is Hanukkah. And we begin to feel the power, the influence of Hanukkah on not only 9, but of course we see it specified in chapter 10 as we moved and transitioned from tabernacles to Hanukkah. And right there at chapter 9, to put the nail that connects Hanukkah to tabernacles, is another Sabbath. So the second Sabbath, chapter 10, as we said, Hanukkah. Chapter 11 is the only chapter in this 20 chapter, in this 18 chapter, 19 chapter set that is not specifically attached to a holiday. And that's because chapter 11 serves as sort of a, I wouldn't say it's a hinge, I would say it is a exclamation point. It is a potent shout out because it contains the resurrection of Lazarus, which prepares us for what we're going to see in 12 through 20, which occurs during the fourth Passover of the book. So again, you're going to see this chart quite a lot through our time together, because understanding the use of festivals in the Gospel of John will help us to understand the context of what's being discussed and included during this period of time.